to rerun all our memories right. It's just a matter of time. Good morning, you guys. Happy finals week. This is like my last major finals week of nursing school because I do not slash am not supposed to have finals on my last term of nursing school. We have like Kaplan exams to do, so it's different. It has already been a crazy week with dead week and trying to survive that, and then now to be going into finals week. The burnout is a little bit real. I thought I would take you guys along on what I actually do to study in nursing school. I don't have a ton of days to study, but we just make the most of what time we have. Right now we are in the prescription phase of my study routine, AKA we prescribe ourselves a study plan and get our lives together featuring many to-do lists. I've already kind of gotten started on the list, but the main plan is to one, make a list of when and where I need to be next week. And then we have what's left of semester three. We have four things left on this to-do list. That is so wild. This is my Kaplan to-do list. We've got two exams left on that. Those will be proctored on Thursday. I need like today's to-do list on this, and then I'm gonna do each class's to-do list on this, and then I'm gonna do the weekly to-do list on this. Yeah, let's just pour in together what we have to do. Step one, let us organize our lives. The really annoying thing about nursing school is that there are so many schedules everywhere, and I do really miss Canvas. My school uses Blackboard. If any of you have used Blackboard, you know what I'm talking about. It's very disorganized, and every teacher has their Blackboard set up very differently. So it is just taking me forever to figure out where I need to be when. I also have 17 announcements, so it could be in there. Schedule will be posted on Blackboard. Yeah, but where's the schedule? Oh my god, I can't believe I'm wasting my time trying to figure out this stupid schedule. Weekly on-campus folders, I guess. Here we go, finally. 14:30 to 17:30. Okay, so that's 2:30. We have like in general what I need to do. I feel like there was something I'm missing though. I'm gonna study with Erica on Monday. Now that I see on my list, I kinda know how this is gonna go. I'm gonna spend more time studying for acute, obviously because it's a harder class. There's actually more material on it. And transitions, we've been like a little bit better prepared and my grade is higher in that class, I think. I don't even actually know what my grades are. And usually I spend time like figuring it out, but I don't want to make myself go crazy or like cause myself to stay a little too comfortable. So I'm actually not gonna calculate what my grade is and I can deal with that afterwards. Oh, I need to do this CRCM thing. I cannot forget. My grade for acute is like a little bit borderline between an A minus and an A. So I really do wanna try to go for the A. So we are gonna spend most of the time, AKA today, tomorrow, and Monday, and the morning on Tuesday studying for acute because there's a lot to go over. Transitions is really just gonna be the rest of Tuesday and in the morning on Wednesday, but we already had a study guide for transitions and we also have a study session on Tuesday night. For acute, I have a lot to do. I just took a picture of what is on the final exam, basically the exam blueprint of how many questions from each section are on there. So the main things that I need to focus on are one, we have to fill out this organ donation sheet because like 13 questions from our final exam are gonna be about organ donation. The other goal that I have is to go through my Saunders book. And the other thing I need to practice are all med calcs. I'm just gonna write down a couple that I can think of off the top of my head. Honestly, insulin I'm fine with. I should probably do CPP, MAP, but I know MAP. ICP, but I should know the values. There's always med calc questions on every single one of our exams. So it's good to know those because those are basically free points if you can punch it into the calculator and know the formula. Ethics and nursing I think I can handle. I'm not gonna spend a lot of time on that. Adult cardiac is gonna be like a big part of our exam. There's actually 9 questions on adult cardiac. I spend a lot of my time doing practice questions because it's the best way to figure out where there's holes in your knowledge, and I literally just Google them on Quizlet for whatever class I'm in. I've been doing this forever and I search it up, find some practice questions and crank away. Let's see what other things are weighted heavily. Neurological conditions is 5 questions. Oh, adult respiratory is also huge, okay. It's all a game of strategy to figure out how you can spend your time. Yeah, those are what we're gonna focus on in neurological conditions. So those are the ones that I have to do practice questions on. The other things I'm just gonna write on my cheat sheet. especially points that I don't know. Because technically I've studied for all of this stuff already. We just had an exam like 2 weeks ago, so I'm not heavily concerned. But what I'm gonna do is go through every single one of my PowerPoints and add to the cheat sheet. We're not allowed to use the cheat sheet, but if you've watched any of my other study videos, which I will link my entire study playlist down below, because I think in those videos I go into detail more about how I study for exams. So I would watch those, and those kind of go over like how I do it. For nursing school, things are a little bit different, but in general, I focus on practice questions and I still make my cheat sheet. It's just not as detailed as it was in previous classes, because I would spend all my time making the cheat sheet. Now I rather spend more of my time taking practice questions. So I write pointers that help me remember things, and I still love that way of studying. It's a lot more focused on the practice questions because that is key. If there is a nursing point that they are trying to drive home, you're gonna see those on Quizlet, on the Saunders book, in your book, in your teacher slides. Like, it's gonna be everywhere. So that is really my method for studying. So acute, there's kind of a lot to do, but those are like my main things that I have to get done. That is our study plan for today. I think I'm gonna pick out a couple things to do today, and since I have a fair amount of time, I like to bulk up the practice questions to land right before I take the test. So Monday, Tuesday is gonna be mostly practice questions, and the next 2 days are gonna be me filling out my forms, doing my little cheat sheet, just so I'm like ready to go. Let the joy begin. Also, I'd like to mention that it is very important not to spend your entire life just studying away. You will go crazy, and your brain cannot absorb that amount of information because you are just trying to cram it. So like today, for example, I have plans to go play tennis with my friend Caitlin. It's gonna be great. We're gonna get outside, get some like anger out. I just need that to remain mentally and emotionally sane. An assignment. I thought of a couple tips that I thought I would share while I was working on this assignment. One, hide your phone behind places, because I was on my phone for a little bit too much. I took a break and then it lasted too long. I play music because that's just how I work, and it helps me like continue to keep going. My last little tip for you guys is to split your screen. I swear to God, this changed my life. I feel like a lot of people probably know this already, but if you don't and you have a Mac, you click this little green button in the corner. I hit tile window to left of screen, and then it gives me an option of what screen I want on this side. So I always click my Word document here. This saves me so much time because I can just Google what I need here and then type it in here. It's so convenient. Filled this all out. It looks really nice and pretty. Made the colors all blue. I'm gonna export this as a PDF and send it in my group chat just to save people time, because that's what friendship is, and we all are on the same team here, and everyone I know is studying for finals and probably doesn't have time to refill that out. So I'm just gonna send that to them, and it's one less thing to do. My friends always help me out, so I try to help them out in return. It's almost lunchtime. I'm gonna go play tennis in about an hour, so I think I'm gonna go eat and take a little bit of a break. And then when I come back, I'm gonna go ham. I'm good. I put a dress on today. I don't care what you say. And I'm ignoring my phone, so don't try to reach me. Happy Sunday, you guys. We are back to the study grind. We have kind of a lot to get done today, and I'm actually very tired. Today was not good. We did our fun before our work, but I did have a productive morning of doing like a bunch of errands, and I've done 2 loads of laundry, but we're back to our study guide. I would say I'm like almost halfway through all of the lectures and stuff for the cheat sheet that I want to make. So today's goal is to get that completely done, and then my CRCM assignment done as well. It's due tonight, so it's gonna get done. Tomorrow, we're just gonna crank out practice questions and I'm gonna study with Erica. For me personally, I kind of like studying alone first, and then I can study with someone else and we can like talk through everything, and then we're both kind of on the same page. I'm probably gonna listen to some John Mayer. You guys know the drill. This is what happens when I have to suffer for my own consequences of me having fun with my friends today. It was good, it was therapeutic. I got a walk with some horses. It was good for me. I do feel really good about what I did yesterday, and I feel like I understand everything, so I'm in a good place. Cue the time lapse of me studying. Nothing ever stays the same. There's always room for better days. Now I know how to live life with a smile on my face. Nothing ever stays the same. There's always room for better days. I was crying yesterday, but look at me. break. I was like falling asleep on the couch, but I got a lot done. I got all of respiratory done, and I got for adults and peds, and I got peds renal done. And then I was falling asleep and I realized that my apartment was like almost 80 degrees in here because I forgot to turn the AC on. So the AC is now on. We have our laundry here. We're going to fold it up. I'm going to listen to a podcast. This is another way that I study. I love straight A nursing. It's seriously like the best podcast, and they have a bunch of pod quizzes. So usually on Spotify, I just type in straight A nursing and then whatever topic I want to listen to, or I'll scroll through one of their episodes and yeah, I just listened to it. So I'm gonna listen to When Little Lungs Have Big Problems. So I think I listened to this one already. So if it sounds really familiar, then I'll go to the ventilator episode. That's why we got so many problems now. Keep it a con and you don't let it out. You're talking so strange. Because I'm lacking motivation, so I'm giving myself a break. This is what I've been spending my time doing. I've basically been doing this because I don't want to do this stupid assignment. Cashing in my dreams, big payout. Underneath my money tree, big shade out. Now these models wait on me for gave you. Tell me why you're not so cold. Can't you see? Can't wait, I ain't got all day now. Time is money, watch my face, don't show a change. Good morning, you guys. Today is Monday, which means it's officially the start of finals week. I got some breakfast with some friends this morning. I studied this morning, and now I just am gonna put away my dishes before Erica comes. To be honest, I am a little bit behind on my studying. Like, I wanted my cheat sheet to be done. It's just real life. Sometimes your goals don't always happen, and that did not happen this time. We are gonna get it done today, and I feel like going through the practice questions are better anyway, and the parts of the cheat sheet that I haven't done is the most recent information that I literally just studied for like 2 weeks ago or less. We're gonna be fine, but I'm still trying to like get outside and try to mix up the routine because I cannot like just sit and study in one spot for that long. We've studied everywhere, my desk, my couch, other people's places. That is the plan for today. We're gonna whip out the Saunders book so Eric and I can go through practice questions. We're probably gonna go up to the pool area just so we can like mix up the routine and still like, it's still good weather, you guys. We have to be outside. You're from the Pacific Northwest, you understand. When it is good weather, it is like, no excuses, everything must be done outside if possible. I will talk to you guys when Erica is here. I wanna go to party. Also want good grades. I wanna finish high school. Scared of making my mistakes. Erica and I are back from the pool. We laid out there for a while and we were doing really well with our productivity, and then all of a sudden we weren't. So now we're inside. We got ice cream, we got a Thai iced tea, and we are taking all of our Saunders questions from the bank and projecting them on the screen and going through them. It says, like, I highlighted all the topics that we had to do, and it says that we have 1,500 questions, which we will most definitely not be going through today. But we're gonna just do this until our brain hurts and see.
10 more questions.
Yes. No, Erica, no. More. We have to do at least 100. Things are going decently well. The time is now 4 o'clock, so we have less than 24 hours till our exam. Pray for us. We're gonna be fine. We really are. We're doing well, actually. We just got a couple wrong. We gotta Google this. Oh my god, what's the rationale? You guys, it's the nutrition questions that really get us. They throw us. Oh.
Look at that. The oranges are good for vitamin C.
Oh, because you take it with the vitamin C. Oh, we should have been, yeah, on that. We know that.
We should have just stuck with green. Dark green leafy.
We should have just been drawn to the dark green leafy vegetables. That's right. But you know what? Dark green leafy vegetables have everything, so it's really confusing to differentiate because they have every single nutrient that you need. So, whatever. We're getting riled up about these. But it's good. It's a good practice for us.
Exactly.
We got yet another diet question. This is for broiled haddock. I don't know what broiled haddock is. I'm assuming it's a fish. Haddock?
Haddock.
Oh, yeah, it is. It's not. What type of fish? Like a swordfish? Haddock? Okay, I'm gonna click submit because I think we're right.
Yeah.
Yes.
We're right.
All right, Eric and I hit our goal of 100 questions. Do you think we passed?
You passed.
No, you passed. We did it together. This is a great idea if you study with friends, project the questions onto the screen. We did 100 and now we're like kind of addicted to them, so we've made it to 102 because we realized that we don't know our meds as well as we think we do. There's not gonna be as many meds on our exam for tomorrow, so this is not a concern. However, it is a concern for the NCLEX and for our Kaplan exam on Thursday, because I think we are so used to calling things by their brand name, not their actual generic term name. So we gotta work on that, but I'm gonna go study at Katie's and have dinner, and then tomorrow we test. Day. It's 9 o'clock in the morning. We're gonna do our final studying before my test is at 1, so I'm gonna leave here around like 12:10-ish. I'm actually feeling like really good. Good vibes all around. Slept great. Had kind of a weird dream, but like still slept great. I can't believe this is happening. Like, it's my last finals week ever. Even though this term feels like it took forever, this whole program is going by so fast. I haven't even been in school in a year. My backpack is so heavy. Classic finals week. I guess I should give you an update of how we are doing here. Last night I went to Katie's. It was super productive. I finished my entire cheat sheet that I wanted to do. I at first wasn't gonna finish it, but then I was like, what the heck, I'm gonna finish it. And I did a bunch of practice questions as well. So I'm just doing them out of this Saunders NCLEX book. I'll have this link down below if you guys are curious. Look at this, you guys, it looks so nice. The only things I haven't done in this Saunders book are like the adult practice questions. I did all the like peds, cardio, peds neuro, peds respiratory, peds GI. So I'm gonna do adult versions of this. There's not that many practice questions in the book. Like, the online platform for this is way better. So that's what Eric and I were doing last night, and some of the questions I've actually seen already. But I'm gonna do the adult versions of this. We're just gonna crack away here, and then I'm gonna have lunch. I packaged up my books to ship off today because I gotta mail them back to Amazon. And I want to write a thank you card for my professor. That's kind of like what's on my morning to-do list. I'll take my test at 1, come back, study for transitions, hang out with my friend Scout. There's a study session on Zoom at 6. And then tomorrow we take another final. Ah, it's crazy. I know it's probably weird that I like haven't started studying for my other class, but this class really does matter a lot more. And the other class, yeah, the study sessions are very helpful. Like, they literally talk about what's gonna be on the test, which I don't think is right. Like, it's definitely made all of us students a little bit complacent, but we all did fairly well in the OB Kaplan, so we must be learning more than we think we are. And of Saunders book that I wanted to do. I went over all the med calcs and I wrote my professor a thank you card. So it's been a productive time. It's currently 11:45, so I'm gonna leave here in like 30 minutes. I'll probably just check my email and read over my cheat sheet that I made just one final time. I have to put my hair up because it's game time mode. The hair needs to be out of my face so I can focus. I also like want to trust myself and be excited to get this done. This is like a huge accomplishment. This class in particular is a lot. There's a lot of information. I'm happy with what we've done and, you know, we did our best. So that's all we can do. I'll probably talk to you guys when we're at school. So yeah, and I'll let you know how it goes, obviously. And the thing is I don't even have time to be sad, so I can relax for like a little bit after I take the test, and then I'm literally on to the next one. So that's just how finals week rolls. You were born over them and I was born over you. Snapped by the glint of those old glossy eyes, trying to decide if it's clear or we're free. I don't know how I feel. When I finish the test, I'm spending my time going back through the answers that I have like dotted or starred. And so it's hard for me to like feel good because I'm just going through the ones that I'm like stuck on. So that's like what's in my head right now are the ones that I was stuck on. I was just like very in between some. So I don't know. It was hard, but I knew it was gonna be hard. So I don't really know what to think. We'll see what happens. I don't even get my test back today, which is weird because we usually get our test back the same day, but I get it back tomorrow. I wouldn't say there was like anything I wish I would have done differently per se. It's just hard to like gauge what questions are gonna be asked when there's so much information to study. So, you know, they may ask about the thing that you just really don't know. I don't think I failed it by any means, but it's hard to feel like uber confident about it because I did think it was hard. It's good that it's hard because nursing school is supposed to be hard and you're not supposed to like ace every single test, and honestly like acing a final is really challenging. So whatever, it's over, I'm free. I will like, you know, stop being sad girl after this drive. I just need to like emotionally mourn that. I don't know what that is. I wish I could just like know. And also you never know because you don't get your test back, so you can't even see what ones you got right or wrong, which is annoying to me, but whatever. Okay, I'm gonna go relax for a little bit and then we'll start studying again for transitions. Hi, I'm sorry this is sad and not the usual content. I was just sitting in my car getting ready to drop off the textbooks and I saw on the news that 16 people are dead from a school shooting in Texas, and it honestly, I just feel bad for even complaining about having like a hard test. It really makes me upset that these families like don't have their little children coming home with them. I still remember when I was in high school and I heard about Sandy Hook, and it's been a while since we've had an elementary school shooting. Just remember exactly where I was sitting and when I heard the news and how like it just hurt me to my core. These families' lives are like completely changed from this 18-year-old who's killing all these people. It's terrible. So I just want to say I'm really sorry if this is also hard on you too and you feel sad. Even though I don't know any of the details yet, we really do need change, and please vote. Please check in on people so this doesn't have to happen in our world. Sorry, this is kind of a sad note, but I'm really sad for these families. So yeah, I'm probably gonna not film the rest of the day because I just need to study and I'm not really in the mood to film anymore because I'm sad. But it's okay, we're gonna keep going with our lives and just know like how lucky we are that my problem today was having a hard test and not losing someone close to me. So I love you. I'm sending you guys love. I'm sorry this was kind of an emotional day. I'm already like, emotions are already high from finals, so anything like this is just really, really sad to hear. But I love you guys and I will talk to you tomorrow on test day. Good morning, you guys. It's the next day. I wish I could tell you I feel better, but honestly, I'm still in such a mood from yesterday, so I'm sorry, but I'm just not gonna like fake be all happy because I'm processing this, and I've just spent the entire morning watching the news reports. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I'll probably link some stuff down below. Yeah, I'm not gonna like babble on about this forever because that's not what this video is about. I just thought I would address it because I can't get it off my mind. Life is going on while you're in school and it just makes things very difficult. I'm gonna go to school, I'm gonna work hard so that I can become the very best nurse. So God forbid I have to help someone in this situation, I actually know what I'm doing. Yeah, that's a dark thought. We have our transitions final today and then we are literally almost done. I just have Kaplan's tomorrow, which are still part of my grade, so I still need to do well. I think I need to have some distraction. I'm gonna listen to some happy music. I have my pencil. I can't remember if we're taking this on our laptops or not. I should probably just bring my laptop
in case we are.
Last night, I went to a study session that our teacher was having, and then I just did a little Zoom call with all my nursing school friends, and we ran through more Saunders questions. They're super helpful. We just like project our screen up and run through. We did like 75 questions, so it was productive, and I feel like I've done what I could do with the emotional energy that I have left. It just is what it is. And that's real life for you guys. We got the backpack. Let's go. We're gonna feel so much better when this is done. I love you guys. I'm sending you hugs. Whatever you're going through right now, it's kind of a crazy time, so I love you. I'm sorry that things are sad. All right, we are done with our final. It was great. I think it went well. We got our final grades back for our exam yesterday. I did better than I thought, which is good. So yeah, I'm happy and I'm gonna go celebrate with some friends. Good morning, you guys. I totally forgot to vlog me today studying and reviewing my Kaplan. I just breezed over like some Kaplan exams because I have pharmacology today and med-surg Kaplans, each worth 5% of my grade. So I'm driving to school right now and I'm gonna go take these tests and then I'm done for 10 days and I'm very, very excited about it. Last night I went over to Katie's and I just reviewed my pharmacology flashcards. So maybe I'll be a little bit more prepared, but honestly, we'll just see how it goes. At this point, I just see the light at the end of the tunnel and I'm so excited to be done. So yeah, I will tell you guys how it goes. We take it in a computer lab and it's gonna be two tests back to back. So we don't get out until like 5:30-ish. And then I'm gonna go celebrate with my cohort because we only have a couple more times where we get to actually celebrate like this. 'Cause if it's all true. I mean, you know I ain't lying, 'cause I hate wasting time. And you said soon we'll be leaving this place, no life to find. And you were looking hella fine, I was still making up my mind. Are you excited to be done? One more test, one more 75-question test, then we're done? Until next time. We're done. Oh my god. This is crazy. I'm gonna go celebrate with my friends. So I'm gonna end this video here, but thank you guys for watching. I hope you liked coming along studying with me, and I hope things are going well for you in school. And even if it's not, just know that it will get better. For every failure you have, you're bound to have another success. So hang in there. I'm proud of you guys. And today's question of the day is going to be, what motivates you to study? Is it a song, food, snacks? Comment down below what motivates you to study even when you're not in the mood, and I will be sure to reply back to you guys. I love you so crazy much. Give this video a thumbs up if you want more studying videos. Obviously, I still have the NCLEX to take and a lot more studying, even school stuff next term. For now, I get to relax for 10 days until the last term of nursing school, which is absolutely wild. It's crazy that we've made it here and I haven't even been in school for that long. I'm gonna go celebrate. I love you guys so much. Have a good day. Bye. I only worry that I'm crazy, 'cause if it's at all. I mean, you know I ain't lying.